Greetings everyone. Today in the chapter photosynthesis, we will be talking about the stomatal opening and closure. Though we had done it in the previous chapter also, but here we will get some more information regarding the opening and closing of stomata. So before we go to the opening and closing of stomata, let us focus on the structure of stomata. As we all know that these stomata are minute openings. These openings in large numbers on the lower surface of the leaf. The main function of the stomata is to let in CO2, carbon dioxide, from the atmosphere for the photosynthesis. And in doing so, it results into the loss of water as well. So it can be rightly said that transpiration is the price that we pay for photosynthesis. Now, look at the stomata. It is guarded by two guard cells. And one thing about guard cell is that the outer wall, this wall, is thinner than the inner wall. So when the guard cells expand, the inner wall expands less and the outer wall expands more. That results in two, that the guard cells bulging in such a manner that the hole widens. Because if the inner walls would have been thinner, then the guard cells would have been easily expanded in this side as well, making the shape like this. So this, the inner wall would have from here would have come here, resulting into less space for carbon dioxide intake. So the stomata would have closed then. That's why nature has devised it in such a way that the inner walls are thick so that they push open, so that they expand less, and the outer wall are thin so that they expand more, resulting into a bulging outwards of the guard cells, making the stomata wide open. Okay, so when stomata are not in use for photosynthesis, that is when it's dark or at night, they tend to close their openings. Why do they tend to close their opening? Because now, as I told you, transpiration is the price that we pay for photosynthesis, that the main reason might be CO2 intake, but during that time water loss also takes place. So at night, as sunlight is unavailable, or when it's dark, sunlight is unavailable, so photosynthesis can't be carried out. So there is no need for the stomata to remain open, because if it remains open, photosynthesis will not take place, but water loss will continue to take place. That's why, to minimize the transpiration, the stomata closes. Okay, so as after sunrise, they reopen, allowing CO2 to diffuse. So this process, this stomatal opening and closing, there are some theories that explain why it happens. There has been an age-old theory called the sugar concentration theory, and has been a recent theory known as potassium ion concentration theory. We'll focus first on sugar concentration theory, and then we'll move to potassium ion concentration theory. So what happens is, according to this old sugar concentration theory, during daytime, what happens, the guard cells, they begin photosynthesis. So as they begin photosynthesis, so the sugar is produced during this process. Now see, this is a stomata. I'm drawing a stomata, wait. Okay, so this is the stomata that we are talking about. So when the sugar is formed, when the sugar is there in the guard cells, when there is a lot of sugar in the guard cells due to photosynthesis, then what happens? The osmotic pressure increases. Osmotic pressure in the guard cells increases, due to which now there are adjacent cells to the guard cells. There are cells adjacent to the guard cells. So when there is enough sugar, the osmotic pressure increases, due to which they or the guard cells, they draw in water from the adjoining cells. We know this process as endosmosis. So they draw in water through endosmosis, and as water enters here, the guard cells become turgid and they bulge outwards. Now why do they bulge outwards? I just explained that the outer cell wall is thinner than the inner wall, so they can expand more on this side. That's why they bulge outwards, making this stomatal hole wider. Okay, so as the stomata is opened, the diffusion of gases in and out starts, and they fulfill the need for photosynthesis. Now, if for any reason the water content of the leaf is falling short, maybe due to more transpiration, which is more than the rate of absorption, what happens is water is drawn out of the guard cells due to exosmosis, making them flaccid. Now, when they are flaccid, what happens? They sink in. The walls which had earlier expanded, they will sink in and they will take this shape. This will result into the closing of the stomata. Okay, so this is the sugar ion concentration theory, that this happens due to photosynthesis and the sugar production in the guard cells. The more recent theory, that is potassium ion concentration theory, says that the stomatal opening and closing depend upon the generation of potassium ion gradient. So what this theory says is that during daytime, the chloroplast in the guard cells, they photosynthesize. Now that leads to production of ATP that we all know. Now, this ATP is used to actively pump the potassium ions of the adjacent cells into the guard cells. So, this is an process of active transport, because we have learnt here that it has to be endosmosis, that means movement of water into the guard cells. But they are saying that movement of a certain solute. So naturally, due to the difference in osmotic pressure, water will move in. If potassium ion has to move in, then it has to be done by spending some energy, that is by using ATP. So ATP is used to actively pump the potassium ions from the adjacent cells into the guard cells. Now, what happens in the guard cells? The concentration of potassium ion increases, making it hypertonic. So now as it is hypertonic, so more water from adjacent cell is drawn in and the cells become more turgid. They move and they move outwards to open the stomatal pore. The reverse thing happens at night, that is the potassium ions leak out, reducing the turgidity of the guard cells, due to which the stomatal pore closes. That means both tell us the same reason, that guard cells become turgid in sugar and concentration theory, it is the sugar that is, or the glucose that is responsible for the guard cell, making the guard cell turgid by endosmosis. And in potassium ion concentration theory, it is the potassium ion which increases or which makes the guard cells hypertonic, due to which endosmosis takes place and the guard cells swell up. So basically, both the theories are talking about turgidity of the guard cells, that is opening and closing of stomata is due to the turgidity of the guard cell. So what we will do is, the next day we will talk about the main phases of photosynthesis. This is what opening and closing of stomata is, and next day we will go to the process of photosynthesis in detail. Before that, just know that the process of photosynthesis takes place in mesophyll cells. These are the, you know, chief centers, principal centers where this activity takes place. Mesophyll cells are present in between the upper and the lower epidermis. They are of both palisade type and spongy type. These longitudinal cells are known as palisade mesophyll cells. These cells are spongy mesophyll cells. These are palisade, these are spongy. And in these are the sites for photosynthesis. How it happens, we'll focus about it in the next video. So that's it for today. Thank you.